نتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته
Last night after the Tarawih session we touched upon the importance of eating halal food and the importance of consuming halal. And one verse we recited last night, which I mentioned vaguely, was وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا. And today, surprisingly, the same verse was recited because it came again, the same words. But this time, the words were, Allah the Almighty mentions,
كلوا واشربوا ولا تسرفوا إنه لا يحب المسرفين.
That eat and drink but do not waste. Eat and drink but do not waste. So eat and drink, and in light of what was mentioned yesterday, consume, eat, drink halal, but do not waste. Why? Because Allah the Almighty does not like those that waste. And over here, the context is food and drink. So do not waste food or drink. Unfortunately, we live in times where we have many resources, not just food and drink, but other resources as well. But we waste a lot. There's so many people that are poverty stricken, facing poverty, extreme poverty. They're not being blessed with food on a daily basis. They don't have drink on a daily basis. But we are blessed with food and drink, but despite that, we waste it. And it's a very sad state of affairs because Allah the Almighty does not like such people. So whenever we eat and drink, we need to make sure we thank Allah for the food and drink firstly. And then secondly, part of thanking Him is to respect the food where we don't waste it. If there's any left over, then we shouldn't throw it away. If it's in a state where it can be eaten again, then we shouldn't throw it away. Unfortunately, this is happening on a daily basis where so much food is being wasted. I was on the flight when I came and they were providing food when I came here. And they were probably giving yogurts to everyone. And I saw that some people never ate their yogurt. So it was closed, it was tight, packed. So first the air host, whoever it was, he came around to give the food. So he gives the food out, he gives the yogurts, whatever. And then he comes back sometime later, maybe 15, 20 minutes later, to collect the food to see, you know, if you finish and then just throw it away. So I saw there was people that never ate yogurts because they provided yogurts and it was packed, meaning that it was eatable. It could have been given to someone else. But what were they doing? Just throwing it away. And it was just going to the waste. So this is what is happening. And sadly, this is because we have been blessed with a lot. When Allah the Almighty, He blesses people with a lot of things, a lot of resources, food, drinks, then unfortunately, they don't value it as much. But if someone has something very less, then he values it a lot. So if we go to the poor countries and we see people that are homeless, that are sleeping outside, they don't have food, they'll be searching in the bins, they'll be searching in the skips, in the dump yards, they will be actually valuing the food, every little morsel. And that is why our pious predecessors, we learn from their lives. When they used to eat food, for example, when they used to sit on a tablecloth, sit on the floor, or even when you're sitting on tables and chairs, and then there's normally a tablecloth that is spread out. Now, if they were to eat, for example, bread, chapati, roti, etc., then many a times you have the crumbs that are left over on the table spread, on the tablecloth, on the sheet. So what they would do, because they had so much respect for every morsel of food, after eating, they would take it outside. And obviously we can't eat every little morsel, every tiny bit of bread, etc., because obviously a bit of it is going to fall whilst we eat. So what they would do is, they would go outside, and wherever they knew that birds would come, they would throw it there or put it there, and birds obviously would come later on to eat it. So this is how much respect they had for food, and this is how much they understood the importance of looking after food and not wasting it. Obviously, if we do do such things, then it's important we do it in a safe environment. We don't obviously cause more inconvenience to other people, cause more harm, because obviously sometimes it could be a means of mice coming, rats coming as well. So we have to be, you know, very convenient, and we have to use wisdom when we do all these type of things as well. So I pray Allah the Almighty give us the ability to understand the importance of eating and consuming halal. And then secondly, I pray Allah the Almighty give us the ability to safeguard food, respect food, and thank Allah for every single morsel that He has blessed us with. And may Allah the Almighty safeguard us from wasting any type of food and drink. Ameen. Subhanahu wa bihamdi. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين اللهم ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار اللهم اصلح لنا شأننا كله اللهم ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب
آمين
يا الله please forgive all of our sins يا الله please forgive all of our sins يا الله through the blessings of this blessed month Ya Allah, please forgive all of our sins. Ya Allah, please grant us all Jannatul Firdaus. Ya Allah, please safeguard us all from the hellfire. Ya Allah, please grant us all Jannatul Firdaus. Ya Allah, we are in need of your blessings, Ya Allah. Please descend your immense blessings upon us. Ya Allah, we are in need of all types of mercy from you. Ya Allah, please be merciful to us. Ya Allah, we are in need of all type of help from yourself. Ya Allah, please be helpful to us. Ya Allah, please make us from amongst your accepted servants. Ya Allah, please make us from amongst your closest of friends. Ya Allah, please grant us goodness in our lives. Ya Allah, please grant us all long, healthy, and prosperous lives. Ya Allah, please grant us all long, healthy, and prosperous lives. Ya Allah, when the time of our death comes, Ya Allah, please grant us death in a good state. Ya Allah, in the state of saying the kalima, in the state of sujood. Ya Allah, in the state of doing your worship. Ya Allah, please make us from amongst your accepted servants. Ya Allah, please safeguard our iman. Ya Allah, please safeguard the imans of our youngsters. Ya Allah, please make us punctual with our five time daily prayers. Ya Allah, please make us benefit from this blessed month of Ramadan as much as possible. Ya Allah, if zakat is compulsory upon us, Ya Allah, please make us discharge this duty. Ya Allah, if hajj has become compulsory upon us and we have still not carried out this blessed Fard act, Ya Allah, please make us carry out this blessed Fard act as soon as possible when the time of Hajj comes. Ya Allah, please grant us all long, healthy, and prosperous lives. Ya Allah, whoever is going through any type of illness, Ya Allah, please grant them a speedy recovery. Ya Allah, please grant them a good cure and a speedy cure. Ya Allah, whoever is full of debt, Ya Allah, please make them debt free. Ya Allah, whoever is going through any type of trial and tribulation and hardship around the world, Ya Allah, please grant them ease. Ya Allah, please grant them ease. اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك من نبيك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك من نبيك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين
I think it's for Imam.